Okay, so we're going to show you the Stampin' Showcase submissions, and I'm going to actually write their name on the post-it note at the time that I open it to show that their submission is going in. And then I also have some cards that I received last month that were not part of the submission, but I want to show you the cards because they're just so beautiful. Mary asked about my bracelet. Mary, I'll give you the link to it. It's on Amazon. And yeah, it's not cheap. I think it's like $80, but it's worth it because I never take it off unless I go to the hospital and they make me. So yeah, I wear it 24/7. Okay, so here we go. Here's the first submission. This is April, and the theme for April was men and women. So it could be birthday, it could be anything that had to do with men or women. So this card is from Bonnie, and I have to tell you, this card stumps me because I really don't get it, but I will eventually figure it out. So watch this. So there's no color, and watch this. You bring it up. Look, I'm still flabbergasted. I don't really know what this technique is called, but isn't that so cool? So look, no color. And color. I'm confused. Anyway, okay, so that's Bonnie's. So I'm gonna write Bonnie. And I'm gonna fold it and fold it. And we're gonna put it in the basket. Actually, let's put it here. Okay, so that's Bonnie's card. Very neat. Does anybody know what that's called? It's a magic card. I like it. I'm gonna have to figure out how to make that. So cool. Okay, my next card is, isn't this beautiful? Look at that. So my request for cards, it doesn't have to be, but I do request either 3D projects or Fun Fold. So I'm loving the Fun Fold. So here's this one. Don't know what this is called either. Never made one like that, but looks pretty cool. And this card is from Mary. The next card, I've not made this one either. And it opens up like this. Let's see. Oh, wait, come back here. I forgot to put Mary's post-it note. Hopefully y'all not in a hurry today. I will say this. I'm going to try to go live again this weekend. Just a random post. Okay, so opens up. Look how cool that is. I have no clue what this is called, but very neat. Isn't it? And this is from Pam. Oh, it's called an arrow card? Thank you. You know what? I'm going to write this on here. She may have wrote it. Oh, she did. She wrote arrow card on there. I just didn't read it. And look how beautiful this next card is. Oh my gosh. I love it so much. This is from Maya. Look at this. You can't see the shine on it, but it has some shine to it. So beautiful. Look, I cut myself today opening the paper shares twice. Not that y'all wanted to see that. Okay. Now, I didn't get a lot of submissions. I will say they're getting a little bit, I'm not getting as many. So this is a pretty neat idea. I think this is from Lisa. And look, it's like a little keychain. Yeah, this is from Lisa. And look, so she has those little heart charms. So if you're looking for a little cute keychain, okay. The next one is from Vicky. Look how beautiful this is. I love post-it note holders. In fact, someone reminded me the other day, they're like, you know, you haven't made post-it note holders in forever, and you used to do them all the time. You're right. I did used to do them all the time. What happened to me? I'm going to start making them again, especially after seeing this. Okay, so it opens up, and look. I'm actually going to use this. I have a habit of hoarding things and not using things, like beautiful things, you know? And then it's like, what in the world am I waiting for? Like, use it. It's kind of like the quilt I've made my sister. It's like, she won't use neither one of them. I'm like, Kim, use the quilt. I'll make you another one. She's like, no, something could happen to it. I'm like, I'll make you another. So I'm going to use this. Okay, so this was from Vicky. Isn't it pretty? This is another card from Pam, and I have to tell you, I love this card. I gotta make one. Okay, look at this. So this one arrived late. You guys know the mail system is not what it used to be. Anyway, but we're entering it because it should have gone in last month, but it didn't because it didn't arrive. So I have one other card. I think it was a birthday card that arrived late, but that's okay. Okay. Sorry, Stephanie. I butchered the ribbon in opening this. Yes, the post-it notes was from Vicky. So several of my downline participate in this. So yay. And this is from Stephanie, and it is unbelievable. Let me open it up. So here's the box that it holds. So look at this. Hold on. Now I know it's hard to see. It's hard to see, but Stephanie, what is this called? Did you tell me? I don't know what kind of card this is called, but it is unbelievable. I know it's an easel, but I don't know how you did these curved thingies. Yeah, it's beautiful. Pen holders? Oh, Cheryl, that was you. It's a book fold? Well, it's sure awesome. Put it back in its box to protect it forever. Okay, we gotta write Stephanie's name on a post-it note. Oh yeah, it does look like a book. You're right. Okay, now, let's see. This card is super cool. She included the envelope. This was my favorite pattern of paper in that pack of paper. But check this out. Let's see. So, isn't that amazing? Oh, so cute. Who would have thought to use, well, yeah, it has the little hat. Why not? This is the new gray. Who is this from? This is from Nancy. Nancy, I love your card. It's very different. And that is Nancy with a Y. Okay. I actually do have I have a Nancy with an I that is one of my customers, so. Let me put her card in here. This is she say what kind of card it was? No, but she did give me the measurements. Isn't this so beautiful? This is also from Maya. Look at that. Well, let me open it up and let you see the inside. Look at that. This is just beautiful. Okay, that goes in there, that goes in there. And then this card is from Terry. Now, Terry sends cards every month, but she wrote a little note on the top here that says, "Hi, Angie, I ran out of the form." So this is her card, but she ran out of the form. So I'm just going to, I wrote it on a post-it note. Isn't that beautiful? Okay, so Terry. Now, this one cracks me up. I laughed really hard at this one. Happy birthday. I got you a cake. But I ate it. Isn't that funny? Which is so typical, too, of goats, because they will eat just about anything. Paper, you name it. I got you a cake. But I ate it. So, this is from Kim. And my next submission is our final one, and Pam has done it again and again and again and again. Oh my gosh, she is spoiling me. every time I open the package, it just gets better and better. So here's the first little project that she sent, and you slide off the belly band. And look, she made me a little needle book that has embroidery needles on it. So cute. And look, it's got Skittles. Little Skittles. I was watching a video yesterday of her on my head sleeping. okay, the next one, same thing. It has a belly band. I'm so glad I can finally take these things out and have them. Yay, pretty pins. I love everything that's made by Lori Holt. Everything. You can tell this is her cutting pad. So, yay, now I can use my pretty pins. So, she buys gifts and then finds ways to package them. But look at all these layers. So, she embossed this little dress form with Skittles on top. I love the detail. Here is my card, which, look at the detail. So, yay, we have brads again. So, we can use brads. So, she used brads to attach these little scallop circles. And then inside here is my card. Look at that cat. So beautiful. Open it up. Let's see. How do I open it? Then it opens up like this and like this. So, amazing, right? Okay, there's the card. And then last but not least, I squealed when I saw this. It's just a pocket. But isn't it brilliant? Like, we sometimes forget that you can just create a pocket. So I love it. And I have some nifty needles by Lori Holt. 70 assorted needles. Thank you, Pam. I love everything. You're spoiling me. I don't know why, but thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, so now I have some cards to show you that were sent to me, not as a submission for Stamp and Showcase. So that's all of them. We'll draw the winner in just a minute. It'll sit right there. I won't move it. I won't touch it. So here's some cards that I received. This is from one of my downline. This is Leslie. She always makes the cutest cards also. So here is the inside. Isn't that so fun? Let's see the envelope. And then this one is from Betty. That's a cute card. She stamped on her envelope as well. This is from another downline. This is from Jenny. It opens up like this. She sent me a thank you for one of her downline gifts. I send incentive gifts every single month. And this card is from Trisha, another downline. And this one is from Mary. And I should have showed you this one last month, but I think it was in the stack with this. And then this one is another thank you from Margaret. And last but not least, I got a card from Stampin' Up! From Shelly for reaching my 2.3 million. So isn't that cute? Okay, so now we're gonna draw the winner. What were y'all saying? I was looking to see. Pam should have gotten more entries. You know, do you think so? Do all of y'all think I should give her one more entry since she sent? I think she should get one more entry too, right? Do y'all agree with me? We're going to give Pam one more. She did send 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, I think she deserves one more. But she did win last month. So if she wins again, I might have to draw a second winner. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna reach in here. I'm not looking. Maya! She just joined my team, by the way. She had two entries because she sent two cards. So, Maya, you've won. That is amazing. She just redeemed some chick rewards, joined my team, and now she's earned $25 and product of her choice. So, thank you guys, everyone that submitted your projects. I love them. I've saved all of them because I've told you guys when we began this that I'm going to donate some of the projects to one of the local schools. I will say that some of them I can't part with. So some of them I'm keeping for me because they're just, I can't get rid of them. I cannot. Okay, do you guys have any questions for me? I'm sorry I don't have a project for you today, but I have paper shares in the foyer that just arrived, and I've got art gallery class packets to get in the mail, and I don't have an assistant. It is just me, myself, and I, although Brooke did help me a little bit, and David will not be able to help with the paper this time. Grr! He said he was going to help me, and then it seems like he's always out of town when I have a big project. So anywho, if you guys, Gail asked if I have, yes, this is my fabric basket, and I do have a video on my website. In fact, it's probably my most watched video ever now. Gail, I'll give you the link to it. It's really simple to make. It's really simple to make. Yeah. I'm addicted to making them. It's a good way for me to use up my fabric, though. Thank you for guys for saying congratulations to Maya. She's going to be thrilled. What was I saying? Oh, about this weekend. If I can do a sporadic live, I will. And what I'll do is, I know the other night, what was that, last Tuesday, I gave no notice at all. I just basically hit the live button and went live. So what I'll do now, after I heard from so many people say they wish they'd known, I will make an announcement on my Chicken Scratch Stamps group and give y'all like a 15-minute notice. So if you're not a member of the Chicken Scratch Stamps group, you can join it. Join it, please. Can you get the link for the bag too? Yes. So what I'm going to do as soon as I sign off is go upstairs and have a quick bite to eat. And then this was Maya's card, by the way. One of them. After I eat my lunch, I will answer all of y'all's questions that I didn't see and give you the link to everything that you asked for. So the link to the fabric bag video. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to sign off. It's 12:40. Any relation to... Oh, y'all are talking to each other. I'm looking at the questions. I'm like, I don't know what that means. And then it dawned on me. Okay, y'all have a great day. Thank you so much.